Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm going to speak about prompt engineering. What is a prompt? A prompt is simply an instruction that you send to an LLM. What is the color of the colors of a flag? What who was the president of the United States in 1981? Translate this sentence from English to French, etc. It's a simply is again an instruction that you send an LLM and you expect to receive an answer that is correct, adequate, informed and content and has the right length according to what you how you parameterize the LLM to respond. And then on, what is the prompt engineering? The prompt engineering then is a series of techniques which help you to develop and optimize prompts. And this way, you is also helping you to understand the limitations and of the LLMs and getting better answers or doing a correct and better job in when an LLM is answering you a question. Okay, so today we will do some examples of prompt engineering, very basic, using essentially OpenAI models, ChatGPT, well, GPT-4 and GPT-3.5 Turbo, and also we will use Mistral Mistral models, specifically a 7 billion parameter model, which today is very popular. And we can you will get a grasp of what is possible to do also with public models and not with a commercial one like GPT-4 or GPT-3.5 Turbo. To use the OpenAI models, you need to have an account and using the SDK of OpenAI to interact with the models. So you need to you can do the same with the playground. Just if you are starting, you want to do the same, you can do it as well with the directly in the playground, like here, going to the. But you want to use the SDK, you need to create an account. In my case, I'm paying a quote every month, and well, once you have your account, you need to create in the APIs a key to you later on be able to access the models or query the models through the SDK. Okay, so I'm working in Google Colab, as in other tutorials. Here, just make a small note. In these days, when I'm recording this tutorial, OpenAI is changing the API. There were some of the models where the commission and some of the classes on the API had been as well decommissioned. So in order to do this tutorial, I had to install a relatively old version of OpenAI SDK. So, but well, just to be careful which version you install, because probably some of the, if you don't install the correct one, some of the test I did here, it will not work in your site. No, so we install the libraries, we import OpenAI, we get the key from Google Colab Secrets, and here, well, just this is one very simple test. We are asking to a GPT-3 Turbo instruct that generate three trivial questions and answers. Notice that this is using already the old interface, the completion interface. This today, if you install the new library, it will not work. Just to consider that, no, yeah, it's pretty simple. And that's it, no? You can see here the new interface is the chat completion one. No? We will see it later. Two considerations to have at the time that you are doing prompt engineering. First of all, is the number of of parameters that you need to, well, that you can parameterize in order to fine tune how the model behaves, no? When you send a prompt or when you send a question or a instruction to the model behaves differently depending on the parameters that you set up on the config of that model. Most of the model shares the same parameters, and then and here in this page I will post it later. In well, it's already post, it's already here in the links I'm passing to you. But well, there's the temperature, which is essentially manage the randomness that the model is going to use to generate the next token, and then on random temperature close to zero is essentially not use randomness and just use the probabilities that had the model calculated during training. And if you get a temperature close to one, it's using more randomness, which drive to the model to not use the most likely token, next token, when they are, the model is generating text. No? Top P, that essentially is used among the top P, top N, let's say five tokens, among of the five most likely tokens, or sea, only use the most five likely tokens to generate the next token in my answer. Max length, which means essentially you had a maximum length of tokens to generate, let's say 300, 500. There is always a maximum length of the model. This means that the maximum length that the model can generate. It's not grown in GPT. 4 is 32,000, so you need to be aware of that, and every model has their own limitations, their own limits. So but here you can regulate the maximum length of tokens that the model is going to generate for that prompt or for that specific question or instruction. Stock sequences, this means that it is a number, so it's a series of string or a list of string that stop the generation of tokens. No, if you can say, yeah, okay, when you find this word on the prompt, stop the, or when you find the this word on the answer, stop the generation of next sequences. Frequency penalty, this is essentially you apply a penalty when some tokens appears. So this means, for example, the word English, no, in a, I don't know, whatever, in a paragraph. If you use many times the word English, okay, the probably the model is doing the job, is producing 1,000 tokens, but the most of the words are the same, and then this is a text that has no sense, no? And then we use the frequency penalty to just say, okay, these words, if you use these words, you suffer a penalty. This drive the model to don't use some words that are very popular or are very related to the model and make a more rich answer, no? And presence penalty is something similar. It said if I use this word before, if I use it again, is receiving a penalty. If I want to present it in my next answer. So it's important to you understand what means all these parameters. There is more, but probably the most relevant are these ones that you can see here on the screen. Also, I will pass you the link and you can see it. And the next two topics that you need to understand from LLMs is two things. First of all, that models only can answer you what with information that they were used during the training. And I will give you a very simple example that you will understand this very quickly. So, for example, I'm using here ChatGPT, GPT-4, sorry. This is the ground rule of ChatGPT. So, if you ask the model who is the Prime Minister of UK, today is 23 of January 2024, the model is answering you. Yeah, exactly. Sorry. As for my last update is Boris Johnson. Well, this means that this model, obviously, when the model was restrained, that was the Prime Minister of United Kingdom. Today, obviously, you know that it's not Boris Johnson anymore. It's Sunil Ronak, and well, the answer is wrong. No, so. What I want to show you with this that for new information the model in few words is not inventing anything. If you expose the information to the model will be able to answer you. There is some techniques that we will speak in other tutorials how to overcome this problem, but well, it's pretty clear that if the model didn't see the information before, the model cannot answer you. And the second one that is very interesting topic, specifically that apply to the prompt engineering, that models, and there is a lot of research about that, and then one of the main is this, is that models are, how the title states, zero-sum reasoners. So the models itself, they are not able to do reasoning like a human is doing. They are pretty limited for now. They make a lot of improvements, but still they are very limited. No? I prepare here an example of what this exactly means. This is an extension of what is in the paper. This is a research paper, very popular. You need to read it. I extend it a little bit because in any case, OpenAI make very good job. To be honest, in the job of the, especially mathematical reasoning, no? Which is what we are seeing here, no? So I asked the model, so you can read the question, in average Joe throws 25 punches per minute, but depends on his average rate, blah blah blah. Well, you can read later on that, and then you can see that the model is not calculating correctly. This is a pretty simple mathematical exercise, and the model itself is not doing correctly the calculations. No, for example, I'm saying that when the average rate is below 75, you punch five times more, and if the heart rate is above 110, the punch average is reducing at 20%. Then we had a fight with five rounds, 3 minutes per round, and an average heart rate was 70, 73, 80, 100, 120. If you look at how the model calculate, average heart rate 70, punch per minute 25, which is wrong. This falls on the category of below 75, it had to be 30, no? Well, the answer is wrong. So what they state on the paper, that's just introducing this small trick. Let's think step by step. With this is already prompt engineering. It's just you are forcing the model to do kind of the mathematical reasoning. No, they try to write the same model. You think it's exactly the same model, but you are forcing the model to think, you can say that, no? And here, just with this simple question, you can observe as well that the answer is different, and then here the calculations are correct, no? So he is saying, is breaking down the calculations in steps, and then on producing the right answer. What I want to say with this is, well, prompt engineering is a key art, no? It's a key process that will help you to tune those models in the correct way and produce in order to produce correct answers for your business case. No? It's key how you build the prompts, how you we will see other techniques. This is a pretty simple example on how you can use the prompt engineering to enrich and to drive the model to answer correctly. Well, here I make again. I think I explained you before the chat completion, which is the new API. They are the commissioning the completion, and then if you use the new libraries, you will have to use this one. No, which essentially is going to give you the same. But here in the completion one, you cannot use GPT-4. The highest model that you can use is GPT 3.0 Turbo. And then on here I had the same with the GPT-4, and here, well, the model is was training with other information, and well, is giving you another answers. Again, here for all this model in these two classes, apply the same parameters, and again you can go to the documentation of the Hugging Face, because this applies as well for all the public models in Hugging Face, all the LLMs that they have there, and also in the documentation of OpenAI. Okay, what more? Here I want to speak about tokens. No, what are tokens? Tokens. Let me think where I had this. The first of all, why is important to know what are tokens? Tokens is the way how the LLM break down the text. No, so and what this is important because the models have a limitation in the number of tokens that they can answer you back, and in total these tokens, well, the prompt and the answer make the how to say this total. So if you make a very long prompt, you will be limiting somehow the answer that the LLM is going to give you. And then on, you need to know how this the model is going to break down the test in tokens to you later, make first of all calculations to calculate the cost, how much in the case of you are, if you are using OpenAI, is going OpenAI charge you for the use of the model, and also to limit the answers or the prompts and build correctly the prompts in order to get as well the correct answers or more or less rich answers. To do that, you can do it. There is some web pages that you can use to just how to say write a text, and it will make a breakdown of the of how the specific model is going to split the text in tokens, or you can use the Cryptic Token, which is a library that you or OpenAI use together with the models. You just simply install the library, you get the model. In this case, it's a CL100K, but you can write here GPT-4 or whatever. For example, this here, you had this, and you pass the test, and it returns you the number of tokens that the model is going to use, no? Is going to generate, no? And again, it's important because, well, there is a different. You can go to the documentation, how much it costs per token. Per token, the use of these models, and if you plan to use GPT-4 or GPT 3.0 Turbo in your project, is a question that you need to know, because later on it can come an invoice, a high invoice, if you plan to use this intensively on your project or in a wide use. No, so and how you know this as well. Again, here we are just sending a query to the pricing. You send a query. I think I had here, I put it here, let me exactly. It is exactly, sorry. You can put a text here, it's on the simply that test, and you see here how the model, in this case GPT-3 or GPT-4, is going to, this is provided by OpenAI. You cannot use it with other models, but well, if you want to use it with other models, you need to use this token. But here you can see how, you can see here tokenization, this is generating two different tokens. It's not a single word, so here the count is two. And then you can also see on the answers that OpenAI is giving you. For example, here we are just using the model for language translation, text translation from English to Spanish. And then you can see here the prompt had 35 tokens and the completion, that is what the model is answering you, had 8. In total, OpenAI is going to charge you for 43 tokens. Again, just imagine that GPT-4 had again 32,000 tokens, and if you use this in an application intensively, many users are using this, at the end of the day it's going to be a big cost. Then on, I want to start with this topic, the different techniques at prompt. I'm just going to enumerate the most simple one, which is, the most simple one, that is a zero-shot prompting, which is essentially send a question, no? More elaborate or less elaborate to the model. It can be, in that case, I'm using OpenAI model, but you just simply send the question and you receive an answer. We are not going to enter it is correct, which is correct. I want a pet frog, it's in Spanish. Quiero una rana mascota. Well, it's not very correct in terms of the semantically, but okay, it's fine. And then on you had end shot prompting. In this case, I'm using two shot prompting. This is wrong. And in this case, you just sent you just get or drive the model with some examples. For example, you say here that the model is an assistant that classifies text in three different classes, positive, neutral, or negative, and you get some examples. So here is system, this is the purpose of the model. This is telling the model driving the model in how it had to behave. This is the user, a question to the user, classifies the sentiment of the following text. And then here you are simulating that you are the model, what the model is answering. You are giving an example to the model, no? This text is negative. So here you make another example. That is what I say, this is a two-shot prompting. You can do whatever you want the number. I also will give you an advice after that. And here you finally make a second question with an answer as well, and you make the third question, the final question, that is one to what is what you want to know. For example, the model here is answering that this is neutral, no? Okay, it's can be. So I say, well, I don't have a clear stand about politics. Yeah, it's not that you are not here saying anything in any direction if you want to say that. But also notice that here, as much examples we introduce on the prompt, more tokens you consume. Is pretty simple, no? And then you can make here 200 examples, but yeah, and then this will mean that you use, I don't know, maybe 500 tokens, no? And at the end of the day, it will answer you just with a positive, neutral, or negative. There is already some papers, some research that tell that have demonstrated that about 5-6 examples, you will not get any further improvement. So they make a test with 15, 30, 50 examples. When you send the model again more than 5-6 examples, the improvements are very, very limited. So that's why you need to understand how to create correctly the prompts, because you may end at spending money for nothing, no? Okay, here I just create this silly example. I asked the model to generate a poem of 5 lines about sailing on the ocean. Well, you see the model is doing something nice. You can see here the effect of the temperature. You just see here no temperature, practically 200 tokens, and you will see, well, somehow the well, it's less creative. You can get a temperature of 10, and probably the model is probably the maximum is 2. That's right. Sorry for that. Maximum is 2, and here it will see that they say probably nonsense. Now, in also taking more time. You can see here is completely absurd what is answering. So because it's completely random, and then it's answering whatever, it is just using random tests. And then here let's go back to the original temperature, and then on you can set up, for example, 50 tokens, and then on we are limiting a lot, no? Here I think here max token, probably we here have 50 tokens, let's see, probably 10. I think that here obviously can generate 5 lines because we don't have tokens enough. You can say here 1000, but even if you say 1000, I don't think that he's going to write here. It's just creating a point. You will not see ever also 5 lines points with 5000 tokens worth, no? Then on here I make prompts for different use cases, like a text summarization. Just giving a text and make a summary in one sentence is what we are doing there. Information extraction. So what is what we are talking about in this model? We are talking about ChatGPT, question and answer, question answering. So you get a text and you ask a question about something, who developed this drug. OKT3, blah blah blah. Text classification, this is a kind of sentimental analysis. You can do this with other classes. I make a tutorial days ago where you can classify text in 10 different classes. You can take a look on the channel. Conversation, this is start a conversation with a bot or something like that. You are a conversational bot. Here you make you interact with the bot answering you, and then on in the next response you introduce what the model answers you, and a second question. You see here we are using the first, which is the system prompt, then on the user, then on the answer of the bot, and then on you make another use. This is how you build a conversational bots, no? Here I answer you when was founded the Real Madrid football team. I don't know exactly, because I'm not very football fan, very big football fan, but it is like it is. Here code generation. It is asking to generate SQL code. Given these two tables, create a query to provide all the students in the computer science department. Is correct. I can assure that. And here, mathematical or reasoning. Yeah, here is also another problem similar to what we saw above. And yeah, well, this is a slightly easier problem that and is answering correctly the so here I send also the sentence that thing step by step, and here without. In this case, the problem is not very complicated, and even without the sentence is answering correctly. But as you saw in the problem about is in some cases is not answering. And to show that you will see now with this Mistral. Mistral is another LLM very popular these days. Connecting. We just install is connecting. Yeah. Now for this model we are using a GPU a T4. We install the libraries we need. And yeah, this I ask GPT in the playground to generate code to solve the problem. Given this list, generate the code, no? And then, well, it's doing a very good job. You can we will check here. So software developers are in risks from now on. They are not going to. They had now a very big competitor with the ChatGPT with these models. So you can check the code here, and well, the code is absolutely correct. Probably you can do it better, but well, it's working, no? Now we are going to use the Mistral. Well, just to give you an idea, Mistral had different models. This is a 7 billion models. Is a really small in comparison, even with Chat, with GPT 3.5, which had 175 billions parameters. So this is a small model, but you will see that make very good job as well. And there is a lot of how to say room to improve the model just using correctly prompt engineering. But first of all, this model you don't have to pay for that. It's free. You just download it from Hugging Face and ready to use. Just without any even optimization or fine-tuning that, as we see in other tutorials I posted on my channel. Just taking the model with 7 billion parameters, which well, in a simple domestic GPU you can use, also in a cheap template in Azure, Google or Amazon, you can use this model without any problem because it's relatively small and doing a very good job in comparison with what we had to pay in OpenAI. It's taking a while to download the model. Now we are here configuring the model, some of the parameters. There is a class. This class works with all the models, all LLMs in Hugging Face, also with all models of OpenAI that are available, like GPT-2. We create the test streamer. Test streamer is just how to say a streaming of tokens. You will see how it works now. We create a pipeline with essentially is like an inference object, but and then where we say that is a text generation pipeline. The model, the tokenizer, we return the full text generated. In this case, it's going to have a maximum of 2048 tokens. We are using the generation config that we have here. Just return one sequence, the most likely sequence, and n token and padding token. Every modem have different end tokens and padding tokens. You have to like read the documentation to understand how to send instructions to the different models that we had available, and use the streamer that we define here in this cell. So we prepare a text, and then we are sending essentially the same paragraph, the same text that we send here to GPT-3.5. And well, Mistral without any tuning, yeah, is doing not very good job. But again, here I think with some prompt engineering we will get the same outcome. This is the streaming. What you are seeing here is just is generating token by token in real time. No? So well. Here is making a mistake because, well, he's summing up all the numbers in the list, which is wrong. We need to choose the odd numbers, which is 15, 5, 13, 7, and 1. And well, he's just simply, but probably my English is not the best, and then probably, yeah, there is plenty of room here to do this. Here I tried again with another prompt, a little bit more depurated, giving an example, and then on, yeah, here you will see what the model is doing. And here is giving you a very rich sentence. What I want to show you is the same that the GPT-4 and GPT-3, you can do it as well with other models. There is very good models on the available on GPT, sorry, on Hugging Face, and well, with some prompt engineering that in next tutorials you will see how to do this better, and we will be doing this exercise again with more techniques that we will learn later on. You will see how the Mistral or other models, we will try others as well, can do the same that the GPT-4 and GPT-3 without paying a single penny. So here you will see, I suppose that is yeah, here, yeah. Here is creating a function that defines odd numbers, and then well, he's actually wrong. Well, it's not actually wrong, just he's only missing some of them. 15 and 13, they are not there. So probably I need to get, yes, yeah, sorry. I give here a wrong example. Ah, no. It's, the example is correct, no? So odd number 7 and 1. Yeah. Probably we can do a more rich example, and probably this will be working properly. So I promise that for next tutorial we will get the same the correct answer with the Mistral. Yeah. So finally we can see the sum of odd numbers. Yeah, it's giving us practically a lecture here. But you see, it's doing a reasoning, a chain of reasoning, is wrong, but again, we can do it. We can get this done. So the matter of the saying that here use not temperature is because we are doing reasoning, no? And then in this, in a chain of reasoning, you don't need to be creative. You need to tie it to the facts, no? And then in mathematical reasoning, you cannot use any creativity. If a number is odd, and it is not, it is even. It's not creativity there. That's why we use a temperature of zero. But well, in any case, the model is not giving the right answer, which is wrong. I want to show as well here the same, but with the transforming this or answering this this code question, and here is doing correctly. Again, we need to understand the limitations of the models, how to use them, and then prone engineering is going to help us with that, and also to get the best of every model and to do it efficiently as well, no? Spending, it is possible, $0 or £0 in my case, no? So you see here the he's answering correctly. We had two tables, departments with department ID and department name, students with department ID, student name, and then we select student ID and student name from the table students, which we get an alias of S. We join with department with alias D on S department ID equal to S to D department ID, where the department coming from the where we can say here as well S department is equal to computer sense. So the answer is correct, no? And that's all for now. I hope that you enjoy with this tutorial. I think that is pretty nice, pretty interesting, the prone engineering. I forgot almost. I recommend you also you to take a look to this company, which is doing also a fantastic job in prone engineering, Lamini. And they make very good job in this matter and also in other topics related to LLMs. And okay, that's all for now. Thank you for watching me, and if you like this topic and what I'm doing, just give me a like and subscribe to my channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you, see you soon.